The Palma was one of my top three e-reading devices for 2025, and you can find out the other two in the video link below. However, this device was not perfect out of the box. In fact, I didn't use it for the first 6 months because it was so unbelievably slow, and I was just really overwhelmed by all the configurations it offers. But once I finally took the time to play around with the different settings and get it locked in, I ended up loving this device. So I want to save you guys some trial and error and show you what worked for me. To get started, open the Reader app on your Palma. Most of the settings I'm about to show you will apply to the Palma's global settings, but some of them pertain specifically to Reader, and you'll need the app to be open for them to be applied. Once you have Reader open on your device, swipe down from the upper right of your screen and tap on E-Ink. I set the dark color enhancement to 70, light filter to 0, and high contrast off, all of which will improve the look of text and images. Changing the refresh rate on my Palma made the biggest difference for me in overall usability, and I would personally recommend setting your refresh rate to either balanced or fast. I experimented with some of the others, and anything slower literally made me want to throw this device out the window. After you've set your refresh rate, go ahead and click on optimizations. I kept the DPI at 350, and then I toggled on eliminate font aliasing, which made the text look slightly crisper. I also turned off the option to fully refresh the screen when switching pages. Under color optimizations, I left everything at 0, but I did turn on this image smoothing option. I maxed out the icon color at 255 and left everything else at 0. I also turned emboldened web page text on, which again helps with legibility if you intend on doing any reading in a web browser on this device. From here, you can go back and move to other optimizations. If you want to prioritize saving battery power, I recommend turning off Stay On in the background. With that said, if you plan on using Reader's text-to-speech or want to listen to music while using other apps, you should turn this on so that those apps can run in the background. Here, you can also turn on the option to use your side buttons for scrolling. However, I just let this off since we already have a setting for this inside of Reader itself. And then I set Remove Startup Animation to on, which made it much faster to open my apps. Getting into Reader specific settings, you can open up a document and then tap the double A icon at the top, which will take you into the appearance settings. Here, you can switch from light or dark mode, or set this to auto adapt to whatever you've set for the device-wide theme. You can also adjust the font and line spacing, and then if you tap more styles, you'll find different text justification options. You can also choose if you want to scroll this document continuously, or have it broken up into pages, similar to what you might find in Kindle or iBooks. The scroll settings you set here will only be applied to this specific document, but I'll teach you later in this video how you can set your preferred scrolling mode to apply to all documents in your account. By default, Reader will auto-detect if you're on an e-ink device and turn on what we call e-ink mode, which is a composite of a couple different settings that improve text visibility and scrolling on these sorts of devices. If you prefer, you can also turn e-ink mode off and selectively enable these different settings. If you leave the document view and go into your Reader account settings in the bottom right, you'll see the option to turn on and off various features, including your page scroll preferences and long form reading defaults, which will apply a more minimalist UI to certain types of documents. You can also customize your swipe and headphone gestures if you plan on using Reader's text-to-speech and want to rewind or highlight using your earbuds. One thing I have noticed with the Palma is that the ghosting can be quite heavy when reading in dark mode. The good news is you can quickly clear this ghosting by swiping from the upper right-hand side and using this full refresh button, or by adding what they call the Navi Ball to your device, which is basically the small button that lets you quickly access different device actions. You can customize these actions by holding down on the Navi Ball, which will take you into your Boox device settings. By default, the Navi Ball comes with 9 different pre-programmed actions, but you can par these back by setting the actions for some of them to none. I personally just set 4 actions for a much more minimalist look. You can also go into your Boox system settings, tap on display, and then set the screen to fully refresh every 10 taps, which I found was quite useful, especially when reading in dark mode, to automatically clear some of that ghosting I pointed out earlier. In the same section, you can also customize your home screen layout and lock screen background using one of their defaults, or you can even upload your own image. And then lastly, you can customize the actions on this lower dock underneath the system navigation settings. So that's how I configured my Boox Palma for the optimal reading experience. If you guys have any questions, feel free to drop them below. Thanks so much for watching and happy reading.